His Excellency, the Governor General of Papua New Guinea. Mrs. Matane, children, family, people of Guinea, in our East Ukraine province, all ministers of state who are here, today is somber and solemn moment. All members of parliament, more importantly, one of our founding fathers who remains standing with us today, the Right Honourable Sir Hubert James. The members of our diplomatic corps, members of our security forces, I pay special commendation to the commander of our defense force, Brigadier General Gilbert Papu, and your members who pay your respect to our senior statesman who is lying in wait. Moderator of the United States of Papua New Guinea, Reverend Bernard T.I., and members of the United States family who are here, especially the two wives, who sang lovely songs of comfort for us this morning. All distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, today is again another very sad and solemn moment. And I join our citizens and our residents across our beautiful country to pay tribute and be farewell and also celebrate the life of this very remarkable man, the late Grand Chief Paulias Matane, GCL, GCMD, OBE. We are here to greet a fellow man who once walked amongst us and had a significant impact on us as a country. He belonged to an era of leaders, both political and economic service, who broke ground. They found themselves in situations which called for them to stand and make their mark. The first Chief Chef Paulias Matane was one of such men. A man, small he may be in physical setting, and humble he may be in his spirit, but he was a man with a big heart, and a giant of a man, in fact, a man who lived among giants from our nation, those who helped save and form what is Papua New Guinea today, a united nation of one people, one language, one tongue, one constitution, living under one democracy. And as I stand with him today, I cannot help but miss of those who have passed before him. In fact, this year, we celebrated the life and passing of many of those giants of our nation. We started this year with the passing of the Right Honourable, the late Sir Michael Waraka. We celebrated, sadly, the passing of the founding father of our nation, the great Grand Chief of our country, the Right Honourable, Sir Michael Thomas Bryan. We celebrated yet again passing of the 7th Governor General of our country, Sir Salas of Paraguay, and today we now sadly celebrate the passing of the 8th Governor General of our country, a giant who lived among giants of his time in shaping what is happening today. This class of Papua New Guineans, as I say, Paulias Matane was amongst them. They found joy in service. They look into others and saw that he belonged to his wife, he belonged to his family. He was truly a proper leader who united our nations. In grace, in humility, in service, in tolerance, in forbearance. One who was willing to change ideas and ideals, his joy, his wisdom, a moment of his sadness, so that others around him can equally find their own path in what was happening. His life was a life of service outside of politics. Unlike many of us, when we ascend to prominence, we choose to find the earliest path to politics. He was the complete opposite. Just to remain faithful in his pursuit of the service of our country. Rose to the highest, served as United Nations, served as Secretary of State, retired early on time, but he was still under 55, chose to go back to his village in between 1985 to 2004 when he became an 8th Governor General. Four elections passed by, he chose not to contest elections like many do. He remained a rural base, truly an authentic Papua New Guinean branchie who remained a service where he was called, living service amongst his people. What a character to emulate. What a person that I was dumbfounded to hear his achievements in life. No one book can contain his achievements from since he was birthed on to his passing. He is really an epitome, a reflection of how God can use a humble person who truly was a blessing, not just his family, but all of who lived around him and the country that he and today I just come here to pay respect and say thank you to his wife and Julian, as well as to all who have personally related to him, his children, his family, his grandchildren, his great grandchildren. Thank you for allowing your father, husband, wife, your mother, and grandfather, great grandfather. Relative to be shared and to be giving to allow that he gives his time to serve Papua New Guinea in the way he serves through public service. That in my view is unequal because he was purely public service. From being a teacher to a government leader to a diplomat and to a head of state, he belongs to that class of Papua New Guineans who did not see politics as the only pursuit of life or service to them, but who remain loyal to the calling through public service. I pay acknowledgement to his faith, the teachings of the great United Church of our country, who are able to ensure that this patriarch and gentleman remain entrenched in his strong Christian values that also guided him to his life of true service to our country. I just want to take time to wish him a wonderful voice. And for those of us who are here today, may his testimony, may his life values and characters, may his examples be a guide to anyone to serve in the public service. For you can't just be a politician to contribute to our country. Wherever God has given you your talent, dispense your talent to the betterment of our country. He serves in retirement as a Boy Scout patron, a Girl Scout patron. He worked in the National Library at that time in service. He assisted the National Museum in service. He was a patroness of many important charities of our country. That is the calling our God requires of every company. Wherever you are called, use ballot for the service of your country. But surely as we were born into this country, let us thank chef of each and every one of us, and thank of the exceeds. The Bible reminds us of the time and season of my wedding in the good, chapter 3, the time to born and the time to die. But there are quite a time for him to rest and to await the second coming of Christ after years. We call to rest. For those of us who are listening, including the children, our time is still ticking, and we are alive. And in honor of him, and I thank the council, that the Grand Chief, Sir Paulias Matane, was a rule of public guinea, some was a rule of public guinea, and we are trying our best to ensure the rule of public guinea is unlocked. For those of us who are living today in this moment, they will be reminded our time is close to coming for you to go to when. Whilst we have daylight in us, it is given upon us to be who service to our country according to the talents that the Lord has placed on us. Wherever we have placed the struggle of serving in our country. May God bless the soul of Sheriff Paulias Matane. May God bless this family. People are sleeping with them, and as children. So the house.